Thoroughbred Week with John Henderson is presented by Actistan, Adena Springs, Breeders' Cup Challenge Win and You're In Series, Claiborne Farm, Darby Dan Farm, EmpireCityVets.com, Florida Thoroughbred Breeders and Owners Association, Jerry Parks Insurance Group, Keeneland, Malone's, New York Thoroughbred Breeding and Development Fund, OCD Pellets, Old Colony Insurance Services, PBI Bank, Quillen Leather and Tack, Spendthrift Farm, and Windstar Farm.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Thoroughbred Week, featuring a handicap star who scores a Grade 1 stakes double at Santa Anita, along with a recent private purchase who captures the Grade 1 triple bend stakes. We begin with sprinting fillies and mares at Churchill Downs in the Rock Savannah Stakes. Diva Express, the 9-10 favorite, Travis Stone picks up the call.
Three furlongs to go, Diva Express, but here comes Ramona's Wildcat with more pressure now. Those two come outside the quarter pole. Farther back, I'm a Looker finds a seam in between horses, moving up to be third. Athena's in fourth, Milam's fifth, pretty fancy right there to sixth. Anyone's race, turning for home, Diva Express in front off the turn. Right there, Ramona's Wildcat, I'm a Looker trying to get on track, and Athena's got a shot on the far outside, and Milam is stopped in behind horses. One furlong to go, Diva Express still in front. Ramona's Wildcat, Athena outside, Milam nowhere to go down inside. I'm a Looker switches back out. Time's running out. Athena comes away with the lead and pulls off the upset. 18-1 on the wire.
Long shot Athena, the winner by a length and a half over I'm a Looker. Brian Hernandez Jr. aboard the Keeneland Sells graduate in 109-3. Winner of the 38 Go-Go Stakes at Laurel Park last December, the Helen Pitts trainee was coming off a fourth place finish against Allowance Optional Claiming Company at Churchill Downs. The 4-year-old filly by Street Sense was bred in Kentucky by Gary Trevenel. Athena has earned nearly $230,000 for Mary Grom. Brian Hernandez with the Safe Ride of the Week, presented by Sally Horse Fans, the safest way to the winner's circle. To Santa Anita for the Desert Stormer Stakes, sensitively the 1-2 favorite, Michael Rona has the call.
She's ours in the front of Sensitively, each boasting three consecutive wins at the top of the stretch in the Desert Stormer. And she's ours in the front by a half length, Sensitively moving up to her. And two lengths then to Luminance coming home strongly. Juno is fourth past the eighth pole. She's ours digging in doggedly. She's in front by a length and a quarter, moving away again from Sensitively. And she's ours too good. Has beaten Sensitively fair and square with Juno third.
The longest shot in the field, she's ours at 13-1. The front running winner by a length and a quarter over odds on favorite Sensitively. Victor Espinoza aboard in 107-3. The first stakes victory for the James Cassidy trainee, who is undefeated in four starts at Santa Anita this year. The 4-year-old filly by Tis Wonderful was purchased by DP Racing for $145,000 as a maiden-winning 2-year-old. She's ours has earned nearly $177,000. Darby Dan freshman sire Dialed In, sire of impressive 2-year-old debut winners at Churchill Downs and Santa Anita. Shalon became Dialed In's newest winner after capturing a $56,000 maiden special weight at Santa Anita. To Arlington Park for the Grade 3 Chicago Handicap, Sarah Siss, the 9-5 favorite, John G. Dooley has the call.
They round the far turn with inside, three furlongs to go. Half mile and 46 and 4/5 seconds. It's Sarah Six from Cathpaloo, seeking treasure right there, run zippy run. In between horses, you barter right there at the point of attack. Mink Surprise being ridden with Alex Solis's whip. Tis Lately is dropped back. Sweet Southern Dame and last as they strained was City of Tricks. There's a furlong to go at Sarah Siss and Cathpaloo. Cathpaloo charging at Sarah Siss. And these two come down toward the final half furlong. Sarah Siss is finding. Holds Cathpaloo. You bought her third. Mink Surprise and Seeking Treasure. Sarah Siss takes out the Chicago handicap.
Sarah Siss sets all the fractions to defeat Cathpaloo by a length. Jose Valdivia up in 123 flat. Sarah Siss records her first victory since she won the Grade 2 Raven Run Stakes at Keeneland last fall. The Ingrid Mason trainee was a distant eighth when Terrace captured the Grade 1 Humana Distaff on Derby Day at Churchill Downs. The 4-year-old filly by Sharp Humor was bred in Kentucky by Dr. Catherine Renee White. A $10,000 Keeneland September yearling and a $20,000 OBS June 2-year-old, Sarah Siss has earned $662,000 for Rags Racing Stable. Access Thoroughbred Week replays every Saturday on Thoroughbred Daily News at the TDN.com. To Belmont Park for the Grade 3 Better Roses Handicap. Champion Wavell Avenue, the even money favorite, Larry Comas has the call.
As they round the far turn, the leader is West Coast Check, who continues to be pushed along by Mela. Bar of Gold is outside them, and it's a four-wide run for Wavell Avenue, and By the Moon is behind them in fifth. The half mile is up in 46 seconds flat. Coming to the top of the stretch, West Coast Chick cuts the corner. Mela's alongside. Wavell Avenue makes her move now on the far outside. Bar of Gold is there and running room toward the inside for By the Moon. It is still wide open. Wavell Avenue's in the center of the track. By the Moon has come through on the inside. Bar of Gold is right in at two, and then Mela in fourth, but it is By the Moon. And By the Moon and Jose Ortiz take the Better Roses.
2-1 second choice, By the Moon, holds off Wavell Avenue by a length and three quarters, while in receipt of 6 pounds from the odds-on favorite, Jose Ortiz up in 121-4. Winner of the Grade 1 Frisette Stakes at 2 and the Caesars Wish Stakes at Laurel last season, the Michelle Nevin trainee ran fourth in the Grade 3 Distaff Handicap in her seasonal debut. The 4-year-old filly by Indian Charlie was bred in Kentucky by Samantha Siegel. By the Moon has earned $790,000 for JMS Stable. More racing coming up, but first, here's the upcoming schedule in the Breeders' Cup Win and You're In Challenge Series.
The best seek fame and fortune. The best is elegance at 120 decibels. The best run all day and party all night. The best are speed, power, and grace. The Breeders' Cup. With 13 championship races and $28 million in purses and awards, the best is yet to come.
And Go Zipper is pulling away! Go Zipper pulls them away with an eye-opening performance.
Odds Up Again has won!
Go Zipper kicking clear. Judy the Beauty!
And now, a Florida Thoroughbred history moment. In 1956, a small, feisty horse from Florida named Needles and his owners Jack Dudley and Bonnie Heath shocked the racing world, winning the Kentucky Derby. Needles proved that champions with modest pedigrees could be grown in the Sunshine State, thanks to the limestone-rich soil and spring water. His wild acclaim created the horse capital of the world that we know today. This has been a Florida Thoroughbred history moment.
Quillen has been providing quality leather goods worldwide since 1982. Our custom halters are handmade in the nation's largest halter shop right here in Paris, Kentucky. From checkbook covers, wallets, and a variety of gift items, or one of our famous handcrafted halter plate belts or work belt, all are hand-finished in our leather shop. And for over 30 years, not a lot has changed in the way we do business and the quality of service and products you'll get at Quillen. Quillen Leather and Tag, South Main Street in Paris, or online at Quillen.com.
A rewarding relationship begins at PBI Bank. When it comes to your money, you need it in the hands of people who understand you and your business. At PBI Bank, that's exactly what you get. We understand the unique needs of the equine industry and how important it is to the bluegrass. After all, we are a Kentucky-based bank, and PBI Bank has served its Kentucky communities for more than a century. Come visit our Lexington PBI Bank or visit us online at pbibank.com to learn more about what we can offer you.
Welcome back to Thoroughbred Week with the Ohio Derby coming up in this segment. We begin with turf fillies and mares at Monmouth Park in the Grade 3 Eatontown Stakes. Isabella Sings, the 2-5 favorite. Frank Miramonte picks up the call.
Down the back stretch, Isabella Sings leads it by a length with Invading Humor in second. Then it's Means Well, Camille Claudel. Bureau de Change is widest of all, but only 4 lengths off the lead. Seacoast is traveling well within herself, but she's in some serious traffic, one from the rail, and then it's simply a distance to Nisha Aurora. Around the far turn, Isabella Sings has been there throughout, Invading Humor fully extended, but Isabella Sings, Paco Lopez, just motionless. They're breezing to the quarter pole. Just behind them, Means Well in the orange colors. Extreme Outside, Bureau de Change. Seacoast has the red cap looking for room. They're in the final furlong. Isabella Sings. Now Seacoast has daylight and she's starting to chase her home, but it's Isabella Sings in a dominant, stellar performance, making short work of the competition. It will be Isabella Sings to win the Eatontown.
Odds on favorite Isabella Sings, the front running winner by 3 lengths over Seacoast. The fifth victory on the card for Paco Lopez. Time of the race, 1:40-2. Winner of the Little Silver Stakes over the course last summer and the Grade 3 Mrs. Revere Stakes at Churchill Downs last fall, the Todd Pletcher trainee was coming off a victory in the Miss Liberty Stakes at Monmouth Park. The 4-year-old filly by Escondrea was bred in Kentucky by her owner, Sienna Farm. Isabella Sings has earned nearly $452,000. Isabella Sings paid $280 to win and is the Malone's Favorite of the Week, presented by Malone's, Lexington's favorite steakhouse. To Parks Racing for the Turning for Home Stakes. Majestic Affair, the 7-5 favorite. Keith Jones has the call.
Saffron Hall went the opening half in 48-4. So the pace not fast for Saffron Hall, who goes to the far turn, leading it by just better than a length. Majestic Affair, first one to make a move, and here comes Etruscan 3 wide. Adirondack King is in behind that group. Adirondack King gets a nudge to quicken fourth, and Encryption will be forced 4 wide at the 5/16. Well, they're now coming to the corner pole. Majestic Affair to engage Saffron Hall. Etruscan is 3 wide, circling up 4 wide. Here comes Encryption, and Encryption making a big move out in the middle of the racetrack. Majestic Affair comes off the turn with a short lead, but Encryption is bearing down on him, now on the outside. They're past the 8 pole. Those two now heads apart. Saffron Hall digs in down at the inside. Encryption, Majestic Affair past the final 16. Encryption ahead in front. Majestic Affair right there on the inside. Encryption, yes, sir. Encryption's got it by a head.
5-2 second choice Encryption runs by Majestic Affair to defeat the favorite officially by a neck. A 1-2 finish by Keeneland Sales graduates. Nick Juarez, the winning jockey in 1:43-1. Winner of the Byron Stakes at Parks Racing last fall, the Kelly Breen trainee was last seen finishing third when Breitster captured the Majestic Light Stakes at Monmouth Park. The 5-year-old horse by exchange rate was bred in Kentucky by Greenwood Lodge Farm and was a $140,000 Keeneland September yearling. Encryption has earned $383,000 for Stoneway Farm. Time for 3-year-old stakes action presented by BC2A Paste. Reduce the likelihood of tying up with BC2A Paste. To Thistledown for the Ohio Derby, Mo Tom, the 11-10 favorite, Matt Hook has the call.
And they're off in the Ohio Derby. And it's Mo Don't Know who bounces from the inside off to the lead, cocked and loaded, also has speed, and from the outside, Decorated Soldier will also be part of the pace. Wild About Deb and Van Dam together with the Street Lover to their outside. Things get tight there for that look on your face. Adventist is to his outside, about 5 lengths off the lead. And it's riding in the wind. And Mo Tom is the early trailer. They round a clubhouse turn, and Mo Don't Know is the early leader. Cocked and Loaded tracks him in second. Decorated Soldiers to the outside, racing third. Wild About Deb is in close attendance now. He's on the inside, fourth, about 3 lengths off the lead. Adventist Between Rivals is fifth. The outside Discreet Lover is sixth. Van Dam is seventh. He's 5 lengths off the lead. That Look on Your Face and Mo Tom are together about 7 from the front. And the trailer now is riding in the wind. 4.5 furlongs to go in the Ohio Derby. New leader, Cocked and Loaded. Cocked and Loaded takes the lead. Decorated Soldier goes with him. Mo Don't Know is to the inside, racing third. Discreet Lover is right there. Wild About Deb is bottled up right now on the inside. Adventist is Between Rivals still. Then it's Van Dam. Mo Tom is currently 5 lengths off the lead, and he begins to gain ground. Then it's That Look on Your Face and riding in the wind. They're on the turn, 5/16 to go, and Cocked and Loaded is the one to reel in. Decorated Soldier now takes a shot at him. There goes Discreet Lover, and Mo Tom is also underway. Mo Don't Know along the inside. Adventus is there. Wild About Deb, top of the stretch at the Ohio Derby. Discreet Lover, a short lead, but Mo Tom is finishing with a flourish. It's a trouble-free trip today for Mo Tom. 1 furlong to go.
locked and loaded, trying to re-rally on the inside. Then it's Adventist moving into third. A 16th to go. He'll dot the I in Ohio. It's Mo Tom. And Mo Tom wins the Ohio Derby.
Mo Tom rallies from last to defeat Adventist by 3 lengths. Javier Castellano riding the winner for the first time. The Keeneland Sells graduate clocked in 151-4. Mo Tom captured the Grade 3 LeCompte Stakes at Fairgrounds, but was a troubled third in the Grade 2 Risen Star Stakes, then had to check sharply in the stretch of the Grade 2 Louisiana Derby before settling for fourth. Things only got worse for the Tom Amos trainee when he finished eighth in the Kentucky Derby. The colt by Uncle Mo was bred in Kentucky by Hargis and Sandra Sexton and was a $150,000 Keeneland September yearling. Mo Tom has earned $591,000 for GMB Racing. Spendthrift Farm Stallion Court Vision, the 5-time Grade 1 winner and Breeders' Cup champion from the family of APND. Court Vision is the sire of the undefeated 2-year-old filly Conquest Vivi, who scored a dominant 2.5-length victory in the $125,000 Nandy Stakes at Woodbine.
And here's the wire. It's Palace. And they're coming down to the finish, and it will be Palace. Palace is pouring it on, and Palace dazzles here.
In this game, there's no room for second best.
To be the best, you need the best. Actistatin Equine. Clinically proven joint protection. 3 U.S. patents and 2 clinical trials prove Actistatin Equine is the most powerful joint formula on the planet. Superior absorption helps your athlete lubricate, strengthen, renew. No other product even comes close. Find your best with Actistatin.
Ask your veterinarian or call for a free consultation. 866-587-7333.
Constitution won a Florida Derby, and Constitution has won!
What are you signing up for in 2016? Does he have the strength of the Founding Fathers, top and bottom? What about the kind of speed that sets you apart in quality Grade 1 races?
As they come down to the finish, Constitution in the Don!
The choice is clear. Sign up for Constitution in 2016.
They're off in New York, the premier statebred program in the United States. When you own a New York bred, your horse can run for more than $44 million in purses restricted to registered New York breds. And the New York program pays awards to breeders, owners, and stallion owners when their New York breds finish first, second, or third at New York tracks. We have the quality.
Day at the spa, all the way.
You have the opportunity. New York breds, get with the program, the best program.
Welcome back to Thoroughbred Week with the Grade 1 Triple Bend Stakes coming up in this segment. We begin with sprinters at Monmouth Park in the Mr. Prospector Stakes. Always Sunshine, the 8-5 favorite, Frank Miramonte has the call.
Shaft of Light has come through now. Shaft of Light emerges with the lead 3 furlongs from home and puts a half length on El Deal in second. Then it's Always Sunshine on the outside third. Just behind them, now looking for racing room, one from the rail. Visionary Light and Chublicious is now on the move. Chublicious moves up to take second. He's chasing his stablemate, Shaft of Light, at the top of the stretch, who opens up a 2-length lead. Chublicious on the move, now has to angle out. These are the two, and they are dominating. Visionary Ruler, Always Sunshine, a 16th to go. Shaft of Light or Chublicious. Chublicious is wearing him down. Shaft of Light, Chublicious. Chublicious has got him. And Chublicious has won the Mr. Prospector going away.
Runners trained by Jorge Navarro finish 1-2-3 with Chublicious the winner by a length and a quarter over Shaft of Light. 5 lengths back to Visionary Ruler in the show spot. Tony Gallardo aboard in 108-3. Back-to-back stakes wins over the track and trip for Chublicious, who defeated Statebreds in the John J. Riley handicap in his first start for Navarro and owner Daniel Gruskas. The 5-year-old gelding by Hey Chubb was bred in New Jersey by Joe Dan Farm. Chublicious has earned nearly $263,000. For all your insurance needs, a specialist at Jerry Park's Insurance Group is there to assist you with 40 years of exceptional coverage. Look for Jerry Park's John Cassier, Kelly Weeks at upcoming sales. to Santa Anita for the Grade 1 Triple Bend Stakes. Kobe's back, the 9-5 favorite. Michael Rona has the call.
Racing. Kobe's back at the tail of the field early. Lord Nelson shows good speed with Ambitious Brew, but Subtle Indiana's burning them both off, and Coastline showing good speed down the extreme outside. In fifth position comes Cautious Giant, followed after 2.5 lengths by Clever Royal. He's racing on the inside of Home Run Kitten, and Kobe's back is 2.5 lengths last. Subtle Indiana's the leader, but not in tearaway fashion like last time. He's only got a half length on Lord Nelson as they draw towards the half-mile pole, with Ambitious Brew a wide third. Cautious Giant and moving along the rail within 2 lengths of the lead. Coastline posted deep. Home Run Kitten splits horses, begins to improve in a bunched field. Clever Royal next to last. Kobe's back last, peeling 4 wide. He's only 4 lengths off the lead. At the 5/16th pole in the triple bend, and Smith has rated Subtle Indian to a nicety. Lord Nelson looms within a head. Have a look at Kobe's back. He's up on terms with the leaders at the quarter pole. They swing for home. Lord Nelson, Kobe's back, Ambitious Brew running a brave race between horses, and Subtle Indian still punching away along the fence. Home Run Kitten just behind them, followed by Clever Royal. Subtle Indian with a big kick. Subtle Indian a 16th to go from Lord Nelson. Kobe's back has peaked on his effort, and it's down to Subtle Indian and Lord Nelson. Lord Nelson lunged to win the triple bend by a neck.
2-1 second choice. Lord Nelson runs by Subtle Indian to score officially by half a length. Rafael Bejarano aboard the Keeneland Sales Graduate in 121 flat. Purchased privately by Spendthrift Farm after his third place effort in the Grade 1 Malibu Stakes, the Bob Baffert trainee won an allowance optional claimer at Santa Anita in his seasonal debut. The 4-year-old colt by Pulpit was bred in Kentucky by Clear Sky Farm. Lord Nelson has earned $598,000. The future Grade 1 winner was consigned by Clear Sky Farm to the 2013 Keeneland September Yearling Sale, where the colt was originally purchased by John Fort for $340,000. Grade 1 Triple Bend Stakes winner Lord Nelson, the Keeneland Sales Graduate of the Week. Coming up, a Grade 1 double at Santa Anita.
Grade 1 winner and track record setter Lee is one of the newest additions to the Claiborne Farm roster. The Don Handicap winner traveled around the world and back, competing against the best of his generation. He earned multiple 100-plus buyer speed figures on both dirt and turf, with strong finishes in the Breeders' Cup Dirt Mile, Stephen Foster, Dubai World Cup, and Woodbine Mile. Retiring to stud with more than $2.3 million in lifetime earnings, Lee at Claiborne Farm.
Provides the best coverage with the best service at the best rates, insuring many of the finest farms and horses in the country at discounted rates for over 50 years. Let Old Colony provide insurance quotations from one of its nearly 20 different markets that will compete for your business. Old Colony Insurance, serving the horse industry with strength and stability at great rates for over 50 years. For more information, visit us online at oldcolonyinsurance.com.
Hey racing fans! With EmpireCityBets.com, you can now place wagers from the comfort of home on thoroughbred and harness tracks around the world. Empire City Bets is an advanced deposit wagering service that offers both internet and phone wagering. With EmpireCityBets.com, you get sign-up bonuses up to $300, weekly promotions, and daily rewards on most tracks, including an industry high of 8% on Yonkers races. You also enjoy live video and race replays, and with exclusive content from some of the best handicappers around, there's no other place you'll want to bet. Don't race to any other site. Race to EmpireCityBets.com.
Keeneland September Sales Graduates shine, capturing all three jewels of the Triple Crown with Keeneland September Sales Graduate Nyquist in the Kentucky Derby, September Sold Exaggerator in the Preakness Stakes, and a dramatic win in the Belmont from Keeneland September Sales Graduate Creator.
Creator, too close to goal!
Keeneland Sales, producing more Grade 1 winners than all other sales combined. Keeneland September Yearling Sale, September 12th through the 24th.
Time now for the feature race of the week, presented by Keeneland, investing in racing's future since 1936. It's the Grade 1 Gold Cup at Santa Anita. Melatonin, the 9-5 favorite. Here's the call by Michael Rona.
Racing. Melatonin begins well. So to Lieutenant Colonel. Lieutenant Colonel, the early leader over Melatonin. They're followed closely by Hard Aces. There's no speed on in the early stages. Win the Space is the grey with the white blinkers on the outside, going up within two lengths of the lead. Bala Bali's off the rail already for Pratt. He's followed on the inside by Second Summer, Imperative towards the end of the field, and Opportunity two lengths last. Lieutenant Colonel will do the honours in the Gold Cup. Telemo content to sit second on Melatonin, followed by Hard Aces, who's only a length and a half off the speed with 7/8 to go. Win the Space is next, a couple of lengths to Second Summer. Bala Bali the outside from Imperative, who just drops back a fraction from between that pair, and Opportunity is last. 3/4 of a mile left to go, 11 lengths covering the field, and Lieutenant Colonel enters the back stretch with his ears pricked. A length to Melatonin and 2 lengths to Win the Space. Hard Aces, Bala Bali out to the three path running fifth, a couple to Second Summer with Imperative, and Opportunity by his time 8th and last. Lieutenant Colonel in front by a length and a quarter. Melatonin second as he chases the Big Cap Gold Cup double. In third position comes Win the Space, followed by Hard Aces, Bala Bali, Second Summer, Imperative, and Opportunity at the tail of the field. Into the far turn with 3/8 left to go, Lieutenant Colonel still controlling the traffic from Melatonin. Win the Space, 3 wide. Hard Aces the fence from Bala Bali, Second Summer in the hot pink. A length and a half, Imperative, 2 to Opportunity. At the quarter pole, Melatonin on the outside, moving up to Lieutenant Colonel. They're a length in front of Win the Space, who's running a big race. He makes a line of 3 at the top of the stretch, 2.5 lengths to Hard Aces. Second Summer, fourth, Bala Bali, very wide on the track. Opportunity stays near the rail. Melatonin confronted by Win the Space with an 8th left to go. 3 lengths away, then comes Opportunity, finishing strongly. Melatonin's the leader. He's pulling away close to home. Dave Hoffman's has transformed this gelding into a star stayer. Melatonin wins.
Melatonin powers his way to a length and a half victory over 28-1 long shot Win the Space. A 1-2 finish by Keeneland Sales graduates. Joe Talamo, the winning jockey, in 159-3. Melatonin won the Grade 1 Santa Anita Handicap in March, but was last seen finishing second to FNX in the Grade 2 Oakland Handicap. After breaking his maiden as a 2-year-old, Melatonin was purchased privately by Terabia Farms and was transferred to trainer David Hoffman's. However, he was diagnosed with a neurological disease that forced him to the sidelines for 18 months. The 5-year-old gelding by Kodiak Cowboy was bred in Kentucky by SD Bree ALP and was a $20,000 Keeneland September yearling. Melatonin has a bankroll of $1,218,000. Watch Thoroughbred Week replays online at tbredweek.com. We'll have holiday weekend stakes action from 6 different tracks, including 3-year-old fillies in the Grade 1 Mother Goose Stakes at Belmont Park, turf horses in the Grade 1 United Nations Stakes at Monmouth Park, along with Canadian-bred 3-year-olds in the Million Dollar Queen's Plate next week here on Thoroughbred Week.
Thoroughbred Week has been presented by Actistatin, Adena Springs, Breeders' Cup Challenge Win and Your End Series, Claiborne Farm, Darby Dan Farm, EmpireCityBets.com, Florida Thoroughbred Breeders and Owners Association, Jerry Parks Insurance Group, Keeneland, Malone's, New York Thoroughbred Breeding and Development Fund, OCD Pellets, Old Colony Insurance Services, PBI Bank, Quill and Leather and Tack, Spendthrift Farm, and Windstar Farm. Online at TBredWeek.com.